Israel's intelligence minister has called a draft resolution by Palestinians to the UN Security Council a declaration of war. Yuval Steinitz says the move is a war process and an act of sabotage against the so-called peace talks. Steinitz added that Israel should consider all options, including the breakup of the Palestinian Unity Government, if such diplomatic steps continue. The draft delivered by Jordan imposes a 12-month deadline to reach a final settlement with Israel.
There is no more important American ally in the Middle East than Israel, and it is the place possible presidential candidates visit for fact-finding. This leads to many questions of one who is still considering the possibility. Let's welcome into Midpoint pediatric neurosurgeon and author of One Nation, What We Can All Do to Save America's Future, joining us from Israel, Dr. Ben Carson. Dr. Carson, it's a pleasure to have you on the show, and how are things in Israel today?
Things are fine. Armstrong Williams, my business manager, is here with me, and my wife and a few others, and we've had an absolutely wonderful time because so often, you know, you read about things, you hear about things, but when you actually witness and experience them, you get a very different perspective.
We're going to talk about what's happening here domestically in just a couple of moments here. But first of all, seeing as you are in Israel right now, there is a tremendous amount of discourse between Israel and the United States at the moment. There is a thinking process that the Obama administration has abandoned the people of Israel. And of course, Benjamin Netanyahu has been quietly very critical of the president and his policies toward Israel. What are you gaining from the people on the ground there, and how angry are the people there that America is not 100% behind them when it comes to fighting groups like Hamas and the very, very radical Palestinians?
Well, I haven't really seen anybody who's particularly angry, but I have noticed that a lot of people feel that they've been kicked to the curb and that the United States seems to have an agenda that does not necessarily include cultivating a warm relationship with Israel. And that, of course, creates some degree of problem because also their unfriendly neighbors recognize that and maybe have a tendency to be a little more aggressive toward them, recognizing that we don't necessarily have their back, although I hope that we do.
What would be your sense then as to why, and again, in your opinion, why the president seems to be pulling back so much from Israel and why indeed he has kicked the Israelis to the curb?
Well, you know, I don't really know what his motivations are or what his allegiances are, but I can say that there exists a great opportunity to improve the relationship. One of the things that I've been able to do is learn a little bit more about the technology sector here. It is absolutely wonderful. And the relationships that the United States has had with Israel in the technology section has been extremely useful to both of us. It's one of the ways that the Iron Dome was developed, for instance. But a number of other things, the exoskeleton, these things are going to be wonderful for a large group of people. And what I think is going to be necessary in order to really get things moving in the right way is for us to firmly state that we are behind Israel. Nobody should ever be guessing about that. And the other thing I think that is critical in this area is we have to design ways for the Palestinians and the Israelis to work together, to be able to actually experience each other.
Let me stop you right there for a moment, if I can, Dr. Carson. With a minute left, though, you just brought up a key point. What would be your idea, then, to bring the Palestinians and the Israeli people together?
I think working on creating programs that allow the children to be able to play together, to be able to do projects together, creating more ways and mechanisms for the adults to be able to be together socially, because then they will get to see that the other is not as bad as they thought they were. It's the demonization process that creates so many problems. We have that same problem in America, quite frankly. You know, between, you know, some of the people in the neighborhoods and the police. And, you know, those are things, neither of them are really demons by any stretch of the imagination, but they try to demonize each other. And if we could get a little honesty in those conversations, and a little admission of imperfection on behalf of both sides, I think we could make a lot of progress.
All right, if you would, please stand by, and please have Armstrong stand by as well. We're going to take a break and back with Dr. Ben Carson and a preview of what the president should say when he addresses the American people this afternoon, a press conference that is scheduled for 1:30 Eastern time, and we will carry here on Newsmax. In case you have not heard, the American government has now come out and said that the North Korean government is responsible for the Sony hack attack, the cyber attack, if you will, and that's the movie The Interview and so much more about American security. We'll continue with Dr. Ben Carson, live from Israel, right here on MidPoint.